Wow, what a strange school year this has been, not only for your parents, teachers, and administrators, but especially for you seniors. If you are like me, you would prefer to hear less about flattening curves, wearing face masks, social distancing, remote learning, or anything else related to this pandemic. So for today, with this video, we are going to pretend as if we are all here together, recognizing and celebrating the achievements of the class of 2020. At this time, I'd like to welcome our student body community president to the podium, Levi Streit.
Greetings, guys. It's Levi here. Hope you guys are all doing well and staying safe, and I hope you guys are keeping yourself busy. Things have been crazy the past 4 months, but regardless of that, we still graduated and we made it, so take that with pride. I was trying to come up with what to say for this because, like I said, it has been a long 4 months. And the first thing I thought of was me being me, let's be cheesy. So, you know, life isn't always going to give you lemons, but, you know, it's going to throw you a curveball and you still got to figure out a way to make lemonade with that curveball. There's always going to be those ups and downs in life that we got to overcome. And, you know, at times of highs, you got to remember your lows, and in times of lows, you got to remember your highs. Things are the hardest right before they get better. It's the tenacity and the perseverance that we develop now through these hard times that will better prepare us for the inevitably rough times that will come throughout our life. I hate to be cheesy, but when we finish one chapter, there's another one waiting for us. And it sucks that our last chapter ended mid-sentence, but I'm very grateful to have read it. Bishop Carroll is one of the best things to happen to me, and I'm grateful for attending it. Everything that I went through here better prepared me as a man and put me on the path to where I want to be in life. Our next chapter is right in front of us. We have lots of exciting things coming. We got college, jobs, careers, family, all of that. It's very, very exciting. And so let's face the next stage in our life with pride and joy of what's to come. With all that said, carpe diem, let's go get them, guys. Proud of you. And now I'm going to go ahead and read our honorary procession. So our honorary processional leaders are, for art, Elena Goebel and Hugh No. For athletics, Adrian Nordis and Ethan McMillan. For broadcasting, Ryan Ducote and William Pronto. For cheerleading, Blair Lashley and Allison Mortz. For color guard, Ainsley Stump. For community leadership, Grace Georges, Levi Streit, and Madeline Roberts. For debate and forensics, Natalie Brandt and Dominic Lehman. For faith, Haley Pendergrass and Samuel Schmidt. For instrumental music, Adler Moss. For National Honor Society, Margaret Brandt and Lainey Steven. For our National Merit finalists, Augustine Haig. For newspaper, Grace Smyrna. Patriotism, Brett Bungartz, Zachary Cowhick, Chase Glasscock, Jackson Golden, Matthew Gottschalk, Skylar Hampton, Andrew Hibbs, Samuel Lipinski, Dylan Nichols, Daniel Racine, and Jessica Schmeidler. For Palm Squad, Abigail Conrad, Peyton Hastings, and Audrey Oxler. For Scholars Bowl, Michael Burns and Helen Wynn. For School Pride, Maddie Lane and Phoenix Smith. For St. Benedict Project Lead the Way Engineering Academy, Abigail Conley and Tack Dow. For the St. Gianna Catholic Health Academy, Morgan Richenberger and Cam Taw. For St. Joseph the Worker Construction Science and Trade Academy, Anthony Pham and Logan Teichman. For Thespians, Carolyn Bailey and Drake Dugan. For the Tom Seiler Teaching Academy, Courtney Gaylord and Rebecca Eisman. For vocal music, Noah Georges and Anna Sauer. For world languages, Yuvia Hernandez and Tegan Kendrick. And lastly, for yearbook, Jaden Brown and Riley Peterson. Congratulations, you guys.
The salutatorian for the class of 2020 is Amelia Vopat. Amelia is the daughter of Vince and Misty Vopat. They are members of St. Francis of Assisi Parish. Amelia's GPA is 4.28 and her ACT composite is 31. Salutatorian Amelia Vopat.
Hello, 2020 graduates and families. I would like to thank the parents and the teachers for all the help they have given that led us to this moment. The class of 2020 has been through so much the past 4 years, especially the past several months, but we made it. We can finally say that we've graduated. We have worked over 13 years for this, and it's now been overshadowed by the pandemic. Although these are not the circumstances we were expecting, we should not let it diminish our sense of accomplishment, nor should we let it lessen our gratitude for the extra effort and love from our teachers for helping us graduate. Yes, we lost the last part of our senior year, but we still have our fond memories and our friendships we made the last 4 years that we will take with us into the next phase of our lives. This should be a time of thankfulness and celebration. I'm grateful for the time I had with my fellow classmates. We will always have these friendships and memories. Thank you.
The valedictorian for the class of 2020 is Taryn Lubers. Taryn is the daughter of Patrick and Mindy Lubers. They are members of St. Elizabeth Ann Seton Catholic Church. Taryn's GPA is 4.3 and her ACT composite is 33. Valedictorian, Taryn Lubers.
On behalf of the Bishop Carroll class of 2020, I would like to thank everyone who has made this possible. Friends, family, and faculty have played a major role in helping us accomplish this achievement. The support from the Wichita community during this non-traditional school year has also been amazing, so thank you. I think that we can all agree that this was not how our senior year was supposed to end. We were all looking forward to things like spring sports, senior prom, our last day wearing uniforms, and of course, graduation. It is super unfortunate that the exciting culmination of our high school career has been unfairly stripped from us. But as the old cliche goes, life's not fair. Although at first glance, this situation seems like a major setback, I believe that it actually provides the perfect opportunity to grow. I think this quote by Napoleon Hill sums up the situation perfectly. Every adversity, every failure, every heartbreak carries with it the seed of an equal or greater benefit. If we take a positive outlook on our current situation and any other setbacks we might encounter later in life, we can turn the disadvantages into even greater comebacks. Bishop Carroll has done an excellent job these past 4 years preparing us to handle any adversity that might come our way in this next phase of our life. It is very exciting to be finally graduating, but also a little sad to be leaving the school that provided each of us with so many amazing memories. Thank you, Bishop Carroll, for all of the incredible memories and for the wonderful people you have helped shape us all into. You will always hold a special place in our hearts. I would like to again thank everyone who has supported each and every one of us in our journey. And most importantly, congratulations, Class of 2020.
The Bishop David M. Maloney Award for Scholastic Excellence is awarded to a student who excels academically and has the moral values and leadership abilities that would enable this award to be coveted. The recipient is active in the life of his parish. This student excels academically while having a strong emphasis on the mission of the school in relationship to his faith. The 2020 Bishop David M. Maloney Award goes to Augustine Haig. The Bishop's Crest Award is given to a student who over the 4 years of high school has applied themselves to take full advantage of the educational and formation opportunities in such a manner as to merit recognition. This includes physical, religious, spiritual, moral, and emotional development. This award is pointed to the individual who has made the greatest movement from the beginning of high school through graduation. This award calls attention to the objective of Catholic education, which is to address itself to the fullest development of the whole person. Congratulations to the 2020 Bishop Crest recipient, Peter Georges. Monsignor Arthur Barth Award goes to high school seniors who have taken a minimum of 8 hours of honors courses, earning all A's, with the exception of 1B+, a minimum ACT score of 30, have an outstanding record of discipline, demonstrated leadership, and are active members in their parish and at Bishop Carroll. Our Monsignor Arthur Barth High School scholars are Monica Carrillo, Gus Haig, Elizabeth Herman, Taryn Lubers, Erica Martin, Helen Wynn, Haley Pendergrass, Christian Sponsel, and Lainey Stephen. The 2020 graduating class of Bishop Carroll has one national merit finalist. This student scored in the top 1% of the 1.5 million students who participated in the annual merit program. Congratulations to Gus Haig. The 2020 Governor Scholars are awards program that recognizes the top 1% of each graduating class based on the student's first seven semesters grade point average. The Kansas Governor Scholars are Taryn Lubers, Helen Nguyen, and Amelia Vopat. All the members of the faculty and staff were given the opportunity to choose one male and one female senior to receive the Bishop Carroll and Kansas State High School Activities Association Citizenship Award. Students must meet standards for respect, responsibility, and reverence. We congratulate the 2020 Citizenship Award winners, Margaret Brandt and Michael Burns. Thomas Seiler Memorial Scholarship, which is sponsored by the Bishop Carroll Parents Organization, is awarded to two graduating seniors. Each of our non-athletic clubs and activities turn in names of their members, and one boy and one girl are drawn at random. This year's recipients of a $1,000 scholarship each are Kevin Nguyen and Gemma Watts. Each spring, the head coaches choose one outstanding senior male and female to receive the Bishop Carroll Scholar Athlete Award. To be eligible, an athlete must have lettered in two sports and have at least a 2.75 grade point average. Their names will be engraved on a plaque that hangs in the hall by the senior class pictures. We are proud to announce this year's winners, Ethan McMillan and Adri Nordis. Ethan lettered in football and baseball, Adri lettered in cross country and track and field. The Baughman Company has established a $1,000 scholarship for a Bishop Carroll graduating senior who plans to major in either engineering or landscape architecture at Kansas State University or Oklahoma State University. This year's Baughman Engineering and Landscape Architecture Scholarship goes to Ethan McMillan. We are honored to offer the Joanne M. Beverly Memorial Scholarship. Joanne was a devout Catholic woman who put God and family above all else. This memorial scholarship is awarded to a senior girl who demonstrates kindness and compassion, is dedicated to her Catholic faith, and provides service to others. The Joanne Beverly Memorial Scholarship goes to Grace Eberwine. Chris Norgren was a 2002 graduate and former football coach at Bishop Carroll. He was also a captain in the U.S. Marines. In May of 2015, he was piloting a helicopter, conducting multiple casualty evacuations due to the devastating earthquakes in Nepal. That day, he and his crew were instrumental in saving the lives of four people who they had never met. Unfortunately, that day, his helicopter went down in the mountains, and he and his crew did not survive. The Chris Norgren Memorial Scholarship goes to a student who challenges himself physically, mentally, and emotionally every day and makes a team, organization, or relationship better because of them. The Captain Chris Norgren Memorial Scholarship goes to Samuel Lipinski. The Peck Brothers Memorial Scholarship is offered in memory of RJ and Sam Peck, sons of Karen and Bob Peck. RJ was a sophomore at Bishop Carroll when he passed away in March of 2004. Sam attended all 4 years at Bishop Carroll and graduated in 2012. Sam passed away in June of 2018. Sudden unexplained death in epilepsy was the cause of both of their deaths. Both boys loved being a Bishop Carroll Golden Eagle, and both used their God-given gifts when they were students here. This year, the Peck Brothers Memorial Scholarship in the amount of $500 goes to Anna Huffman. Rita A. Stoltz Farm Scholarship was established in 2011 and is awarded to a graduating senior to be used toward the student's continued studies in the fields of architecture or veterinary medicine. The recipient of this year's $500 Rita Stoltz Farm Scholarship is Janelle Burkamp. Missy Whalen was a 1990 graduate of Bishop Carroll Catholic High School who passed away from cancer. Missy was an intelligent, kind, compassionate, hard worker who loved to read and was a true friend, always choosing to be happy and positive. In honor of Missy's great love for Bishop Carroll and Wichita State University, the 2020 Missy Whalen Memorial Scholarship is awarded to Alondra Lopez Ornelas. Each year, the St. Benedict Engineering Academy Award of Excellence, the recipient is selected by this faculty. For a student to receive this award, they must not only have shown a full understanding of the design process and principles within engineering, but also a great potential to succeed in a post-secondary engineering program. The winner of the Project Lead the Way St. Benedict's Engineering Academy Excellence Award is Ethan McMillan. The St. Gianna Award of Excellence is given to the top-ranking student who successfully completed the Health Academy program. This year's recipient has shown that she is committed to following St. Gianna's example. The Excellence Award for 2020 goes to Morgan Richenberger. The St. Gianna Via Christi Scholarship is awarded to applicants from each semester of the Academy. The student must have successfully completed the Health Academy program and include in their application an essay regarding their plan to pursue a healthcare program of study along with other application requirements. Via Christi is happy to award five seniors with these scholarships: Maggie Brandt, Ashley Den, Addie Georges, Megan Cahey, and Alondra Lopez Ornelas. The faculty awards were voted on by each department and given to seniors that have shown outstanding performance in that particular subject. Please refer to the commencement program for a list of these award winners, as well as numerous other accomplishments, scholarships, and awards for the class of 2020. All awards, medals, certificates will be included in the senior packets, which will be handed out at graduation the evening of July 26. As we end, I want to thank the COVID class of 2020 for being part of our lives, and thank you for letting us be a part of yours. Remember that this opportunity we have today, and quite possibly in weeks to come, disguised as a crisis, but it will not last forever. And I urge you to never underestimate what God can do while we are waiting. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not grow faint. Teach us, Lord, all of us, to be patient. Seniors, remember, Bishop Carroll is your nest. Return to it often. May God richly bless you always.